lawyers can totally get lost in the weeds, right? We get a case and we spend hours and hours and hours and we have this case theme in our minds and we dig. And then we don't stop to think, maybe I ought to check this. You know, that's why I always encourage people, like, use focus groups. Take, you know, a group of 10, 12 people, talk to them about what you think the case is about, the themes, and they'll tell you whether they understand it or not. And it'll really help you from not wasting that time on the wrong case theme, on the wrong story, you know, on the wrong fact. A lot of times lawyers will come to me and think, oh, I've got this great case. You know, it's all about this one particular fact and, you know, it's going to make people so mad. And we do a focus group and nobody even talks about it. And that's the other thing is lawyers will think, oh, well, you just said it. You should have said it again. Like, you need to repeat it. And it's like, no, that's the magic of a focus group. It's the simplicity of it. If you give it to them and they don't give it back, they didn't care about it. I love being creative with focus groups, and I love it when focus groups get creative with me and we talk about how to create a visual and what's missing from the case and what do they really want to know about, but then fitting that in with, well, why? Why do you need to know if the person had a history? You know, why do you need to know about this fact about what color the car was? And they'll tell you, well, that tells you who's responsible, or that you'd see this in the picture, you know? So it really helps, you know, as I like to call it, like revealing the mystery of like what they're really thinking and how they're making decisions.